Welcome back to St. Thomas First Intermission here. The Rockets and Stars tied at one apiece, joined by the voice of the St. Thomas Stars on our sister station, 94.1 MyFM, Andrew Buttigieg, who's also the public address announcer here for Stars home games. First of all, St. Thomas Stars hockey on MyFM, how's it going?
It's going quite well, actually. We've been having a good season off the ice. On the ice, maybe not so much as we would like to start the season. But nonetheless, it's been exciting to do. And I think it's awesome that we can have us here at MyFM, Strathroy and St. Thomas. And then you look at some other markets, too, starting to pick up some radio stations doing some of their games as well. So I think it's great for the community and great for the hockey teams to be able to do this. And it's a great asset for the parents as well, who listen to the games from out of town.
Absolutely. MyFMRadio.ca, of course. Coach Ron Horvat, and I know a lot of fans in the GOJHL not used to seeing St. Thomas at the bottom of the West. What's going on right now?
Well, there's a couple things you have to look at there, and the first thing I point out is look how many games we play. But on the other hand, I think they deserve to be down there right now because they haven't been playing the hockey that they're capable of doing. You have to look at their lineup. Yes, there's a lot of new players on that team, but there's a lot of 20-year-olds on that team as well, and it's a very veteran team, and there should be a lot of leadership. That's where the team starts to crack down a bit. Drew Collinson, who's actually scored a goal tonight, has been quite slow the past few games, and he hasn't been contributing what he should be contributing. So it's good to see that he scored a goal tonight, but we'll have to see how this three-game test this weekend is going to be big for them, because if they lose these three games, it's going to put them in a big hole for the rest of the season.
Yeah, good segue. You'll have the Stars and Rockets on 94.1 MyFM on Saturday from the WMMC. You can also pick up that game on MyFMRadio.ca. Just hit the St. Thomas MyFM logo. Through the offseason, coming to this season, St. Thomas, did they lose a lot of players? Did they have a lot of holes to fill?
Yes, they did. There was a lot of surprises of people that left, too. Look at people like Kevin Zachruk and Justin Clark, who left because of school. I believe Alex Kramasko did the same thing as well. These are good players we're talking about, too. They're not just someone that we're throwing off the team, that they threw off the team. This is good, capable players. And you look at Davis Boyer, went over to Sarnia. You look at Mac Wood, he's playing over at in Stouffville now. I mean, these are capable players that contributed a lot last year and unfortunately aren't back this year for whatever reason. So I do know at Christmas time they're going to revisit, I know one or two of the players in Kevin Zachruk and Justin Clark. We'll see where they sit then. But I mean, they did lose a lot in the offseason and it was a big change. You could tell with the trainers, you could tell with the coaching staff that there was some changes to be made, and there's going to be a lot of transition, and there's still transition happening to this day.
Broadcasting for the Stars, you spent a lot of time with the team obviously on the road trip as we go with the Strathroy Rockets on the road trip. You mentioned Christmas. Is Christmas too late for a team that's struggling to get out of the basement right now?
Yes and no. I mean, it depends how far in they find themselves at Christmas. Knowing this team, I know they can fight through it, and we'll see these games that they have to catch up in the standings. I believe they have 9 or 10 played right now, which is 3 or 4 behind whoever's sitting in first place, which I believe is still Leamington. And we'll have to wait and see where they sit at Christmas. I mean, it's going to be interesting how they respond to this. Not every team has to face this sort of test. And, I mean, everyone faces this test in a season. It's just St. Thomas is that gimmick. We'll see if they can fight out of it, or if they're going to be like maybe a Lambton Shores 2 years ago where they sit down there the whole time.
Tee us up for the broadcast Saturday night and details as to the broadcast.
Yeah, so we get underway at 7:20, and we're looking forward to that one with the pregame show, and it's going to be very exciting. There's a different, I've noticed through the season, and you notice this every time you go to an away arena. I mean, it's adjusting to a rink, and this is the first time a lot of these players are going to be in Strathroy's rink. And me and you both know, and I know a lot of people know, what Strathroy's rink is like. Much smaller than some of the other ones, and it's hard to play if you're a visiting team. Yeah, a lot of challenges in there. Even if you go to Leamington or something like that, Olympic pad, right? There's a lot of adjustments to be made, and with a lot of new players on this team that are still adjusting to every road rink because they've never played in it before, I think it's going to be tough for St. Thomas. We'll see how it goes.
Appreciate your time, and good luck the rest of the way with St. Thomas Stars Hockey on MyFM in St. Thomas.
Thanks so much, Chris, and you guys are doing a great job as well.
Andrew Buttigieg, the voice of the Stars Hockey on our sister station, MyFM. You'll have Saturday night's broadcast from Strathroy. 7:20 pregame show. You can get that at MyFMRadio.ca as well and hop on the St. Thomas MyFM logo. Period summary, out-of-town scoreboard coming up next. You listen to Strathroy Rockets Hockey live on MyFM.